Hello, my name is Roy, and I'll be showing how you can create a GraphQL API in minutes and deploy it in seconds using StepSend. So the first step would be to install the StepSend CLI on your machine, which I've already done. And the second step is to log in with your StepSend account. For this, we can copy this command into a fresh project directory. It will ask for your admin key, which I can also copy from a getting started experience. This will make sure I'm logged into StepSend and I'm able to use the full power of the CLI. Now I'm logged in, I can actually start importing a REST API using the command StepSend import curl. And with this command, the REST API endpoint you can see in the terminal is being introspected and turned into a GraphQL schema. Whenever I press enter, it will first start asking me for a name for my endpoint, which will be api/productdemo. In this scenario. And now it has imported this REST API endpoint in this GraphQL schema, as you can see here. But I'm not going to deploy this yet, as I'm also going to be importing another GraphQL endpoint. And for this, I'll be taking a different endpoint, which has order information. So this will import another endpoint, and we'll also create a directory for this within my project. As you can see, this index file also has a query, and now it's for a different REST API endpoint. And in this index.graphql file, both schemas are being merged into one schema. And now I'm able to run StepSend start and deploy my API in seconds. As you can see, it will only take a couple of seconds. So there are two endpoints. One endpoint is the deployed GraphQL endpoint, which you can use in any project. And we also have a local copy of GraphQL Playground, which I'll be using to introspect this GraphQL API. In this GraphQL playground, you can play with different queries. An example, this query that we've just imported. But also different queries, like the one from orders, which I imported right after. So this data will be pulled from two separate REST API endpoints. But you cannot only introspect REST API endpoints, you can also introspect MySQL databases, NoSQL databases, Postgres databases, and even other GraphQL APIs. Let's continue by importing a MySQL database. For this, you can use the command StepSend import MySQL. You can also run StepSend import PostgreSQL or GraphQL. But today, let's go with import MySQL. It will ask us for our database host. It also asks us for the database name. The username for the database. And of course the password. So with this data passed, it will generate the schemas based on the MySQL database. So it will actually introspect it and make sure that a lot of the tables are being turned into a GraphQL schema. But this is created another file here. Now, of course, I can also start deploying it. But before I'm going to deploy it, I'm actually going to be merging the MySQL database or the REST API endpoint. So for this, I'll be using a custom directive called AppMaterializer. So if we would go to the first curl import, which is getting customer information, the address is now coming from the REST API endpoint. Instead, we can also turn this into data being returned by the MySQL database. For this, we'll be using the AppMaterializer. As you can see, this code is already being auto-completed by our VS Code extension. And in here, I'll need to return the query called getAddressByID, which is coming from our MySQL GraphQL file, as you can see here. And it returns the type address in a query format. So whenever I save this, I can actually redeploy my StepSend API using StepSend start, which will only take a couple more seconds as it needs to redeploy our entire API using this new MySQL schema and also the two queries that we combined. So if I would go back to my GraphQL playground and we just refresh this, my query to get the address is still the same, but instead of getting the address from the REST API endpoint, it will take the address from the MySQL database. And as you can see here, all the other possible queries from the MySQL database have also been added. And not only queries, but also a mutation.